Hey everyone. Welcome to Hot Hips with the option of weights. So if you were looking for a little bit more with weights tonight, a little more of a sweat, grab weights or grab anything that's kind of weighted. I love seeing people working with soup cans and tomato jars. So whatever you have that could be of weight, grab them if you're feeling it. Otherwise, it's a hot hips with a flow. And we'll start in a child's pose. So getting comfortable on your mat, in your space. To focus on the hips, come into a nice wide-legged child's pose. Knees to the edge of the mat. Sink your hips back into your heels. Walk your hands forward, surrendering your heart. We'll just wait for everyone to come in. So if you're just joining in, thank you for coming in tonight. My name's Sarah-Lana Dowd. Loving all the hot shop love and everyone connecting over the next few weeks or how long. And we're gonna keep doing this, stay connected and keep moving together. So for those that are just coming in right now, we're in child's pose, nice wide-legged position so we can start to set the tone into our hips for our practice. Again, had a few requests for weights being an option, so those are always options, and like every practice, you modify the movement, you listen to your body, you modify as you need, and go at your own pace. The beautiful part of us being in our own practice is that you set the tone, you set the pace. Hey everyone, thank you so much for connecting and sharing your time, sharing your energy. So we're in our wide-legged child's pose position, hips back into the heels, hands pressing forward, melting the heart to the ground. And as you connect to your practice, we're going to just observe our breath, inhaling deeply through the nose, holding the breath and allowing it to resonate. And on your exhale, just softly and observe the breath as it moves, allowing the muscles to soften. So for tonight's practice, as we tap into our hips, thought a beautiful intention that we could set collectively as a community is to tap into creativity as we move tonight. So life can be really creative, and with that, we acknowledge our own ability to be creative. So tonight we're gonna tap into that creativity, move freely, let it bring energy to you, and it's gonna allow us to connect with the energy, connect with everyone out there without any time zones, provinces, countries to separate us. We are here, we are in the moment. So nothing's separating us, we are connected. So breathing in, we start to manifest that creativity, bringing it into our practice, bringing it into our body. And take note of anywhere in your body that you may be feeling a little tight, any awareness, any tensions, and think about turning your breath into that space. Filling it up. So as we move through the practice tonight, Let your creativity and your practice bring you some answers. Let it bring you some direction. Maybe some guidance that you're looking for or that you need. And kind of have an open mind and an open heart to what you are creating. Not necessarily in our practice, but moving forward beyond what you want to create. So from our child's pose, we'll come up onto our hands and knees into a tabletop. Hands below shoulders, knees below hips, nice neutral spine. On an inhale, begin to drop the belly and start to tuck the tailbone up towards the sky. From here, charging into the hands, we press through the arms, energy floats up through. And if you have the space, start to tilt your chin up to the sky. Exhale, rounding, curling. Relax your gaze. Think about bringing your chin down towards your heart space. Inhale. Bring it back through to your cow. Open up the heart. Exhale, round curl. So we'll go through a few more breaths, but be really creative with your movement on these next few breaths. So if you feel like kind of swaying your hips here, side to side. Breathing through your cow. Exhale, rounding, and move into your shoulders. And coming back through, again, cow, move freely. Exhale, round curl. Nice flat back, neutral spine. And then from here, we're going to take the knees wide to the edges of the mat, big toes to touch, pressing into your left hand, rotating, lifting, right hand up to the sky. Lift, lengthen. On your exhale, wrap your right hand, right arm through your left, coming in, right shoulder comes down, right arm stretches along. Option to bring the left hand to the top of your mat or wrap it around your back, hooking it onto your hip, and then melt into the pose. And soft rotation of your right shoulder, keeping the heart space open. And beginning our practice with a nice twist as an option and an opportunity for us to release our day. So on your exhale and release it. Think about really disconnecting from your day and disconnecting with your body and your mind. And roll into the right shoulder. Final breath on this side. Bring the left hand back down to the mat. Or if it was at the top of your mat, bring it back through around your shoulder space. Unravel the right arm, reach back up to the sky, counter stretch. Bring the right hand back down to the mat, switching through. Give yourself a moment, neutral spine, flat back, gaze between your thumbs. Engage, connect through that right arm, reach left hand up to the sky. And lift, lengthen, press into your right hand. And feel that energy reach up through the left. Exhale, reach the left hand through, and left shoulder comes down, left hand, left arm reaches, sink back into your heels. Right hand either to the top right corner or wrap around your back. And then roll into it. Taking these softer postures to come into our practice. And we come back to that intention and we think about what we're creating.
what we want to create. And as we move through the practice, know that you are creating a representation of your energy. And collectively, we come together and we share that with one another. Maybe not physically tonight, but knowing that there are several of us now practicing together, moving together. And let that fill you up. Let that connection energize you. Left hand, right hand coming back down, right below the right shoulder. Counter stretch, take the left hand back up to the sky. Lift, lengthen. And then left hand comes back down to the mat. Draw the legs parallel to one another. Land into our down dog, so spreading the fingers wide. Palms pressing into the mat. Curling your toes into the mat. Inhale. Exhale, press into your down dog. Landing into your down dog tonight, take a few moments to pedal out your legs, bend your right knee, drop your left heel. Exhale, move into the opposite leg. And observe the body here. And as we start to move through our vinyasa, we're going to generate heat. Our heart rate will elevate. And drink water, modify movement as you need. Keep honoring your body. Again, the weights are optional. Every movement is optional. Both heels coming back down to the mat. Lifting the hips up to the sky as your heart mounts to the mat. And observe the energy through your arms, through your shoulders. Take a moment to set yourself your own intention. Let this one be authentic for you. A word, a thought that you can keep coming back to. Something that is authentic for how you're feeling today. Bending your knees, look forward, step, hop, float to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale to fold. Inhale, rise up, reach up. Exhale, fold through center, halfway lift, flat back, plant your hands, step, hop back into your high plank, lower through chaturanga, inhale, up dog, exhale down. And take a moment to let your practice land. Every time we come back into your down dog, listen to the rhythm of your breath. Scan your body. Bend your knees, look forward. On your exhale, step, hop, or float to the top. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise up, reach. Exhale, forward, fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, step, hop back, high plank. Align the body. Hands are right below your shoulders. Legs are engaged, core is strong. Again, we allow our inhales to be empowering and our exhales to be encouraging. Never restricting any movement as you engage, focusing on your strength. Take a deep breath in. On your exhale, lower through chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Bending your knees, look forward, step, hop, float to the top. Halfway lift and fold. Inhale, rise. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, step, hop back, high plank. Lower through chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Bending your knees, look forward, step, hop, float to the top. Halfway lift, fold. sinking your hips down into your mat.
Hands reach up to the sky. Shoulders roll back, Utkatasana. Sink the hips down a little deeper. Breathe in, sink down. And we can feel that warmth coming into the practice. Breathe through. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, step, hop back, high plank. Lower through, chaturanga. Up dog. Exhale, down dog.
Big toes to touch, right leg's gonna come up high to the sky. And think about charging up that right leg. Then bend your knee, guide your heel towards your hips. Straightening your leg. Stepping through for warrior one.
Again, if you have the weights at home and you wanted to incorporate that, grab your weights, reach the hands up. Sink down. Beautiful, if you have the weights, bring them together. Triceps, come down, down. Continue with your breath for 3, 2, hold. Take the arms down into cactus. Shoulders soften. Open heart. Arms come back through. Reach up. Inhale, lift, lengthen. Exhale, take the arms back down to the mat. Plant your hands. Step back to your high plank. Deep breath. Lower through, chaturanga. Inhale. Exhale.
Big toes to touch. Left leg reaches up. On your inhale, think about supercharging your leg. Take it up to the sky. Bending your knee, open up your hips. And as you inhale, taking in your day, just let it fill you up. On your exhale, let it go. Straighten the leg. Look forward, step it through, warrior one. Again, if you're working with weights, grab them. Hands are gonna reach up to the sky. Shoulders roll back. Soft shoulders. From here, an option to stay in that traditional warrior one. Hands are reaching to the sky. Breathe through it. If you have your weights, bring them down. Shoulders roll back, biceps. Come up, down, five, four, three, two, hold. Open up, heart. Sink into, think about charging up that right leg, heels pressing into the mat. Take it in, reach up, lift, lengthen, exhale, bring it back to the mat. Step back, high plank. Lower through, chaturanga. Up dog, exhale down. Bending your knees. Look forward, step, hop, float to the mat. Coming into a second chair here. Option again to include those weights if you'd like. Grab them. Sink up into your chair. And gazes up to the sky. We think about the strength in our legs here. Opening up into cactus arms. And with or without weights, move here a little. In. This movement is so amazing for your shoulders, for your rotator cuffs. For 5, 4, 3, stay seated. Last one,
hold, reach up, lower. Release the weights, plant your hands, step back into your high plank. Inhale, hold high plank. And the hips are gonna get a little funky here. Come into our spider planks. Right knee is gonna come by that right elbow, so take it out, switch. To the left, to the right, to the left, for three. Get at your own pace with your own breath. Last one. And cycling through chaturanga, always option to come onto your knees as you lower through your low push-up. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, curl the toes. Lift your hips back up into your down dog. Big toes to touch. Reach, extend the right leg up nice and high. And think about what's filling you up in this practice and what you're creating. And we're letting it manifest. The body, mind, bend the knee, rotate the hip open a little bit more. If you're feeling funky tonight, you want to flip your dog, take it all the way over. Press the hips up, reach, extend. And if you're staying in your three-legged dog, and encouraging that strength and energy to reach through the leg. On your next inhale, we work back to our three-legged dog. Step the right foot through your hands. Staying into a crescent lunge, again, option to grab the weights. If you're incorporating that in your practice, both hands reach up to the sky. Shoulders roll back. Hands come back together. Triceps down, up, down, up. For five, four, three, two, one. Hold hands up. Slowly bring the hands back down to the mat. Release the weights if that's in your practice. Hands to touch back down here. I'm gonna come to a standing split. So pressing into that right leg, trusting the strength of your right side. Press into it. Left leg's gonna reach up to the sky. Soften your gaze towards the right knee. On your inhale, lift the left leg a little higher. Connect with your breath. We're gonna lower down so that the hips are aligned here. Charge up through the heel. So the legs are creating a bit of an L shape. We're going to pulse left leg up, 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 up. For five, four, three, two, hold. Relax the gaze. Step the left foot down beside the right, hanging into a forward fold. Grab opposite elbows. You can soften your gaze some more if it helps to bend the knees here. Bend the knees and shaking your head side to side. And it's really moving authentically here. We come back to our intentions, that authentic word, mantra, thought, idea that you have for your practice. And knowing that as we move, we're creating it, we're manifesting it. On your inhale, reach up to the sky. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step, hop back, high plank, hold high plank. Second round of spider planks, take it out, left, right, left, right. Breathe through. Exhale as you bring the knee up towards the elbow for three. Last one, hold. Cycle through. Again, always option to bring the knees down here, modify.
Big toes to touch. Left leg's gonna reach up, extending. Got so much energy moving through. Side bodies, heart comes down to the mat. Bend the knee, open up your hips. An option to stay here, or if you're feeling it, flip your dog, guiding through. Again, always the option, if it's there for you, to move a little deeper, take a full wheel. And the movement options are endless. The ways that we can modify and adjust, challenge ourselves through. On your next inhale, we meet back in our three-legged dog. Send the left leg high. Look forward. On your next exhale, plant it through in your crescent lunge. If you're working with the weights, reach and grab them. Hands are gonna come up to the sky. Shoulders roll back. Beautiful. Again, if you're working without weights, stay in your crescent lunge. Hands up. If you're with the weights, shoulders roll back. Biceps up and down. Up and down. And we're creating a lot of energy together, collectively, supporting and helping one another. For three, two, and one. Reach up. Inhale deep. Exhale, slowly bring those weights or hands back down to the mat. Plant your hands down. We get ready to trust in the left side body, engaging, connecting through the sole of your foot. When you're ready, press up into your standing split. Relax your gaze towards the left leg. And then think about that energy moving from the left heel up through to your hip. Right leg floats up a little bit higher. Relax the upper body some more. Leveling off the hips, creating that L shape. Pulse, right leg up, up, up. For five, four, three, two, hold. Right foot comes down. We're gonna heel toe the feet nice and wide here. Into a yogi squat, bringing the hips down nice and low. Hands coming to heart center, rolling the shoulders back, hearts open. Deepen your breath. And if crow is a part of your practice and you want to move into a crow, take flight. Side crow, always an option here too, if you want to move from right to left. Sink into your yogi squat and stay in stillness or dance. Nice long spine. From your sit bone all the way up to your crown, the body is long, open. Hands are gonna come back to the mat. A step back into your high plank. Right leg, left leg, hold. Last round of our spider planks. Take a deep breath and move with your breath. On your exhale, right knee to left, right elbow. Switch, switch to the left, to the right. For five, four, three, two, and one. Step it back, hold. Again, cycling through your vinyasa. Always option to come onto your knees as you lower through. Cobra or up dog. Exhale, curling back into your down dog. Big toes to touch. Right leg extends high. Look forward, step the right hand through, right foot through your hands. Windmill, open up to your warrior two. So the arms come parallel with the mat. Gazes forward and absorb that heat. You created it. And be proud of your movement. Be proud of your intentions. And for you, dedicating time and energy to yourself, to our community at Hot Shop. So much love. So much love. Turn the right hand up to the sky. Reach it up. Option to take that left hand to your back leg or hook it around your back. Finding your right hip and then firing into this lunge. Think about the strength as the heels root down deep. And then from your right fingertips all the way through to your shoulder. Body's nice and open. Coming back to your warrior two. Moving into side angle, right elbow down to your right knee, extend the hand down to the ground, left hand up to the sky. And always option to find a bind here if that's a part of your practice. You can take your left hand behind you, you can wrap your right hand around your leg, binding by your hip. If you're feeling like moving in to a balance pose, step forward and take your birds of paradise. And wherever you are, ignite your breath. Acknowledge where you're grounding. And whether this is your second or third practice, or you're an avid yogi and a yoga every damn day kind of mantra, just know that it's a journey. And wherever you land in your practice is exactly where you ought to be. To never judge or compare, just to acknowledge where you're landing and how you're landing. Slowly come back up. We meet in that warrior two. We're gonna pivot here into a crescent lunge. Hands reaching up to the sky. Both hands coming down to the inside of your foot. Heel toe the right foot nice and wide. Hands aligning. Option to come onto that right left knee if you'd like. Start to turn that right foot into the mat so the pinky toe is grounding, the big toe is lifting, you can see the sole of your foot. And if you're still charged up, the knee can stay lifted. Your option, we're gonna move down onto your forearms if that space is available for you. If you start to move and you acknowledge that it's too tight, stay grounded through your hands. Enjoying the lizard pose. Soften your gaze, look down between your hands. And we're taking the warmth of our practice and now lengthening our muscles, opening our muscles, and creating a fluid motion with energy through the body, from the soles of our feet all the way up through to our crown. Into our fingertips. And a few more breaths on the side. And know if there's any way that you can move a little deeper here, just to explore that space. Maybe bring your forehead down to the mat a little deeper. When you're ready, we're gonna come back into our hands. Right hand coming onto the knee, just softly twisting over to the right side. And if you'd like, add in the arms, reach, extend, right hand up to the sky, beautiful. And think about what you're opening up your heart for. And it can be that intention, that thought. And as you inhale, and really feel it. Feel it enveloping your heart space. And then on your exhale, let it sink into your roots.
right hand coming back down to the mat, heel toe, the right foot to the middle of the mat, coming through for your lunge, gaze down. Exhale, keeping the heel connected to the mat, we take it back, toes pointing up to the sky, the heel stays connected. And keeping the heart open towards the legs here. We're gonna come back into a little bit more movement here. So coming up, hands onto your hips, we lunge and then take it back. Heel stays connected, lunge into it. Exhale, take it back and forward and back for three, two, last one. Sink into it, hands come down. Spread the toes wide, palms pressing into the mat. And acknowledge your choice to move, your choice to set a positive perspective, to be open-minded, to be open-hearted to this process, and to shifting and changing how we move and how we connect. Curl the toes in, lift the knee, press back into your high plank. And cycling through a vinyasa, again, always modify onto those knees if you'd like. Enjoy a cobra. Inhale, exhale through. Up dog, cobra. Exhale, down dog. Big toes to touch. Left leg's gonna reach high to the sky. Lift, lengthening. And all that energy, all that strength to the right side, left side. Inhale, gaze forward, step the left foot through. Windmill, open up, warrior two. Arms parallel with the mat, gaze forward. Exhale, sink into it. And we find so much certainty. And we root down into our warrior. Scan the body. Turn the left hand up to the sky, reach up to the sky. The right hand's coming to your back right leg, or option to hug around, hooking onto your left hip. When you found the depth of your posture, sink down into the leg some more. Gazes to the sky, heart's open. And from those left fingertips all the way through your shoulder, we explore that space. Sink down, breathe through. And we're challenging our strength as we hold these postures and breathe. Continue to sink into it. Send your strength through your legs into your hips. Down through, rooted into your heels. Coming back into your warrior two, we cycle into your side angle. Right hand, right hand to the sky, left hand reaches down. You can either plant it on the inside of your foot or keep it elevated. Choice is yours. Land where it feels right for you. And bind if you'd like, that right hand can come behind you. If you want to hook your left arm around your leg, keeping the heart nice and open. And choice is yours, you have your own space. If you wanna explore into a balance and birds of paradise is in your practice, I encourage you to go there and create movement. We're creating heat in the legs with this hold. Keep rolling that right shoulder back. We have two more deep breaths. Keep sending your breath in the space in your body that's searching for your breath. We'll meet back in your warrior two. Cycling hands back down to the mat. Hold in to your high lunge and hands are gonna reach up for that crescent lunge. We challenge our lunge. One final breath here, reach up. Lift, lengthen, big stretch into the spine. When you're ready, both hands coming down.
option to soften onto your knee, holding your lunge. Just scan the body here. Send your breath where it wants to go. Heel toe, the left foot wide, hands are on the inside of your foot. And we're working into our lizard. Again, know your body, listen to it, and these are your few moments, again, just to explore. So if it feels good, tuck the left toes in. The big toe is gonna lift up. You can see the sole of your foot. And this opens up our hip in a different way. If that feels good, stay there. If not, bring the foot back down. And if that space is available for you to come onto your forearms, lower down to the mat. If not, just think about just softly turning your chin towards your heart space. And length through that right side. And allow yourself to feel here. Sometimes we take these longer held postures and we start to have feelings. We start to really tune in to different emotions and expressions. And for some reason, we think about moving or escaping from it as much as possible. Just think about breathing into it and allow it to land. Allow those feelings, those emotions to be felt, to be expressed. Keep the gaze soft, the shoulders relaxed. Final breath. We'll heel toe the left foot back to the middle. Lunge in two. And then keeping the left heel connected, start to send the hips back and toes up towards the sky. Shoulders are square. Nice long spine. We fold lightly. And feel that length moving through the hamstring. And scan the body. Continue to observe your breath and the energy that you're taking in and the energy that you're letting go of. Hands coming onto your hips. We move through, lunge, and take it back, and forward, and back. I'm just gonna massaging out the hips. Last two. And land in your lunge. Hands coming back to the mat. Curl the right toes in, lift the knee, step back into your high plank. Take a moment in high plank and scan the body from your heels to your crown. And always option to modify onto your knees as we cycle through vinyasa. Lower through chaturanga, up dog, exhale down. And stay in your down dog and scan from the palms of your hands. And take that energy up through your heart space, up all the way into your hips. From here, extend the right leg high. We're moving into pigeon pose. right knee to your right wrist, right heel over to that left hip. I'm setting up into your pigeon. We take a moment, shoulders roll back, gaze over the left shoulder. Make sure that left leg's nice and long. And then right away, we're gonna fold into it. Walk the elbows wide, bring the body down to the mat. And if you have a block or bolster at home, grab something to support you if you're feeling like you want that support in your practice. And holding your pigeon pose, and allow yourself to have a few really deep breaths to connect into it. We're gonna hold this one. And with all that effort and energy from our practice, our heart rates can still be quite elevated here. So by taking this moment in our pigeon pose on the right side, we're gonna acknowledge a shift and change into our breath. While using that heat and energy to allow for circulation, to move your intention and that energy, and allow it to be in a really authentic way. Each and every one of us, we hold energy in different ways. It can be sometimes in our shoulders, our heart space, our hips, our back. And acknowledge the strength in your breath as you inhale, listening to that powerful energy entering the body and mind. And as you exhale, really let that resonate with you. And we'll start to scan the body here. And from your fingertips through the arms, everything's nice and soft here. And sometimes we get into pigeon pose and our hands will start to tighten. So just observe that, maybe even wiggle your fingertips a little bit. And if it helps, plant the palms into the mat. Feel the earth, get grounded. Allow yourself to land. And then so much warmth in that upper body. And as we land into our pigeon pose, it gives us an opportunity to open up that heart space, surrender it into our mats. And along the spine. And just these few moments, our breath, the pace of our heart, the energy has transitioned. And acknowledge that strength that's in your right hip. We are opening up in our pigeon pose on the right side. And so I know at times it can be uncomfortable to hold these postures. But think about breathing into that discomfort. And then on your exhales, again, remind yourself of that calm energy that you possess, that ability to embrace, and your ability to let go. And you have such a beautiful perspective, and acknowledge your lifestyle and choice of practice to bring yoga into your life is a positive one. To do positive things with your body, to breathe and move in a really free way. You're bringing lots of light and love and energy into you. We'll slowly come up out of this posture, and know that if you do want to stay here a little bit longer, allow yourself just to move freely here. To come up out of the pose, just press into your hands, the arms straightened, curl the left toes into the mat, press into your left knee.
lift the body, send the hips back up high. And really authentic movement here if you want to pedal out your legs or even just sway your hips. If it feels good and you want to cycle, cycle through a vinyasa, chaturanga, up dog, down dog. And we'll meet here. Left leg reaches to the sky. Look forward, take the left knee to the left wrist, left heel to that right side. Nice long leg, take the hands back, look over the right shoulder. Nice long leg, beautiful, coming into it. Forward fold, elbows out wide, and grabbing your prop, your block, your bolster, a pillow. And if you were in last night's practice with Sean and I, we all found out that he has a sexy fireman pillow at home. And melt into it. Set yourself up then and turn into your breath. And though our heart rate has come down, still in a working zone, so we're effectively moving energy, allowing for all your efforts, all your hard work from our hot hips, vinyasa, to settle in. And as much as possible, allow the upper body to be relaxed. So we'll start again to scan the body and just observe again our tendencies to tighten up the hands, soften them, press the palms into the mat if that helps. Elbows are wide, hearts melting into our mat. Think about filling up that heart space again through the openness of your shoulders. And along the spine, and visualize the vertebrae. Body, specifically our posture, benefits so much from movement, from yoga, from the combination of a vinyasa that generates heat and warmth in our body. And then we melt into these really nice deep poses to allow for an opening, allow for us to create space. Just like in our practice, every movement, every breath kind of is a part of the journey. And as much as we trust the process and we move with that, we let the symbol of yoga kind of reflect into our life. And we know that each day and each experience that we are living serves a purpose. We're learning and growing and developing from this. So allow your exhale to have that certainty, that calmness, that trust. Keep scanning through and bringing the awareness towards your left hip. Relaxed.
slowly come up out of the pigeon pose on your left side again. Press into the palms. Start to lift the body up. We tuck the great toes into the mat. Press into the toes. Lift your hips. Send them high to the sky. Surrender into a child's pose. So if you're feeling like you want a bit of a stretch for your back, your spine, keep your legs together, send your hips back. If you are enjoying the focus on your hips tonight, separate the legs, knees to the edges of the mat, big toes touch, send your hips back. Again, if you have that block or that bolster or the pillow, you can always kind of place it below you, sink back into it, keep the palms pressing forward. You can also turn the palms up to the sky. If you're working without a prop and you wanted to enjoy a bit of an arm stretch, if you were working with the weights tonight, take the palms together, press the palms and let the thumbs rest on the back of your neck. And so many different variations, so many different ways that we can express in this final child's pose. And land into your child's pose for 10 to 15 breaths. And then whenever you're ready to move into your shavasana, reconnect your spine onto the mat. And just kind of transition any way you'd like. Again, there's so many different ways that we can transition. And a move in a way that feels right into your final shavasana. But in your final few breaths of your child's pose, acknowledge your movement, acknowledge the dedication that you've made to yourself. I know some of us are choosing to connect virtually and practicing yoga at a distance together, and I'm so appreciative that we share that we have this option. And just like we set that tone to connect with that universe with no separation, no time zone, no country, no province. You just feel so much connection. Maybe even more so now than ever. So continue to breathe. If you're moving into your final shavasana right away, find yourself on your back. If you'd like to finish in any other way, you can always do a lymphatic drain or can put your legs up the wall. Just kind of be creative with the space that you have. We're not necessarily in a yoga room, and you have perhaps a little space or more space at home, so just kind of be creative with what we have. But when you land on your mat for your final shavasana, we bring so much gratitude to our mats, and we feel grounded. And we have about a minute left, so if you would like to stay connected for a guided meditation, reconnect, I'll go live again. If you want to do and enjoy your own shavasana, and listen to your breath and scan the body. And thank you so much, everyone, for connecting, for coming and flowing, for practicing hot hips with us tonight. Enjoy the rest of your evening and continue to breathe light, breathe love.